Hello, good afternoon. If I could just get everybody's attention towards the lectern. Good afternoon. Welcome to a very exciting and unique addition to Grand Forks Secondary in our larger community. It is my honor to welcome all of you to the dedication ceremony of the Peace Pole here at GFSS. Today we come together to celebrate a powerful symbol of unity and peace in our community. Maxine Ruzica, the Rotary Club of Grand Forks Peace Committee chairperson, has been working alongside Ms. Archer and the GFSS Global Citizenship Club on this project since the fall. It is my privilege to welcome and invite Ms. Ruzica to address us today.
Thank you so much. I appreciate that. And I'm so pleased to be here today and to share with all of the students and our invited guests this great opportunity that we have in our community. So to get the program started, I'd like to call on Victoria Runt, who is the president of the Boundary All Nations Aboriginal Council, and she is going to do the land acknowledgement and a blessing before we go on to the next item. Victoria.
Hi. So bear with me. I'm stepping in for my good friend Joni, who's not feeling good today. So first, I'd like to recognize the lands that we're all standing on today as Indigenous lands of our First Nation people, Métis people, and Inuit people that have crossed these lands today, and we give thanks for that. So in opening with the blessing, first off, I'd like to thank the Creator for allowing us to all be here today to witness this event. I didn't really study up. My friend Joni gave me the piece of paper for it, but I think the blessing is, with the peace prevail, is to bring peace back as hope to all mankind. The drum song we're going to do will help with that, I hope. And I think it's bringing unity with everybody, regardless of your color, race, gender, your social statuses, or anything like that. And blessing everybody today to, you know, grasp this day as a teaching. And thanking you all for allowing us to be here today. All my relations.
Thank you so much, Victoria. So, here we go, the Boundary Heartbeat Drummers. Thank you so much, Heartbeat Drummers, Boundary Heartbeat Drummers. always enjoy your blessings and your drumming. Next, I would like to call on Global Citizenship Club members, Kenna McGregor and Natalie Herbert, and they're going to have a presentation about what this Peace Bowl is all about.
Good afternoon, guests, staff, and students of Grand Forks Secondary School. And we are Kevin McGregor and Natalie, and we are representatives of the Global Citizenship Club. As the world continues to witness the effects of the war between Russia and Ukraine, we are unable to deny that as humans, we need each other to survive. As members of the Global Citizenship Club, we feel inspired to do our part to eliminate all forms of hatred and prejudice, all things which prevent peace and security in our world. As a first step towards this goal, the Global Citizenship Club decided in September to arrange to have this peace pole planted at our school to stand as a reminder of the hardships people have endured throughout history due to war and instability, and to join the ranks of an estimated 250,000 communities worldwide where peace poles stand. For peace to become a reality, we first need a realistic vision of peace. We need an achievable set of goals to work towards, a way to imagine what world peace should possibly look and act like. The Peace Bowl represents our commitment to the cause of peace and will be the first of many achievable goals that we have, like, done. And planting a Peace Bowl is a way of bringing people together to inspire, awaken, and uplift the human consciousness. And is recognized as the most prominent international symbol and monument of peace. It stands as a silent visual for peace to prevail on Earth. The Peace Pole usually displays the phrase, "May peace prevail on Earth," along with the same phrase in the most common languages of the region where the pole is being placed. The site should have a significance for the community and be publicly accessible. We believe our high school is just such a significant site. The Peace Pole dedications are intended to be personal and community-based events. The planting of this Peace Pole today not marks its first day standing guard over our school, but also serves to launch the second annual community-wide peace gathering being held this Saturday, April 29th, at the USCC Hall. If you wish to attend, please talk to Miss Archer, right there, to get a registration form. We are very grateful to all the school district staff and community members who have helped us to make what began as a good idea into a real and enduring symbol of peace. Thank you.
Thank you, Kenna and Natalie. Next, I'm just wanting to express regrets from Ms. Anna Lautard, Superintendent of School District 51, for not being able to join us. But she has asked our district administrator, Scott Stewart, to come and say a few words for you.
Thank you, Maxine. Good afternoon. It's really nice to be back at Grand Forks Secondary School. Bring greetings from School District 51 and appreciation to the community and the students that have put together this great Peace Pole initiative. When I think about peace, I think of Einstein's quote that peace is not brought about through force, but rather understanding. And as I get older, I try and use that phrase to kind of guide some of my work, and I think about when I've dealt with conflict in my life, that as I aim to get understanding, it's often a better pathway than using some type of force. So I really appreciate the work that's gone into this. It's a beautiful backdrop. I remember that when I first started working at Grand Forks Secondary School and we had a plan that involved the planting of all these beautiful trees, that someday that it would be used as the backdrop for students to come out. And so I'm really appreciative of the fact that the Peace Pole is now situated between the trees that are growing into mature, beautiful backdrop. So again, thanks from School District 51. Looking forward to listening to the band, and thank you.
Thank you so much, Mr. Stewart. Next on our agenda, we have the Global Citizenship Club teacher co-sponsor, Ms. Archer, to come forward.
Good afternoon, distinguished guests, students, and staff. Many months ago, members of the Global Citizenship Club embraced the idea of planting a peace pole on school grounds. We had no idea how to make it happen, but soon found ourselves surrounded, supported, and cheered on by many enthusiastic community members. It began with a positive reception by school administrators, Mr. Foy and Mr. Dowswell. Next, Natalie Herbert and Kenna McGregor of the Global Citizenship Club presented our idea to the school board, where we were welcomed and assured of support. Maxine Ruzica of the Rotary Club of Grand Forks guided our tentative steps throughout the process, always confident that we would meet our goal. An important factor, and one which further solidified this endeavor as a community project, was to source as much of the material locally as we could. We were touched by the generosity of Lime Creek Logging, who donated the gravel surrounding the peace pole and the beautiful stone seating. Sun Ranch Timber provided us with a magnificent cedar pole, which they milled and delivered at a fraction of the real cost. Even the signage has been done locally by Cactus Creek Signs. I would also like to thank Les Johnson, a local videographer, who has volunteered his time to record our event free of charge. And David Reed, the operations manager of the entire school district, who took time out of his busy schedule to ensure that we met the deadline our club had set months ago, April 27th, so that our ceremony could symbolically launch the community peace gathering being held on Saturday. And a huge thank you to Shannon Wolf and the Grade 9 Band, who stepped up with next to no notice. We would like to thank everyone involved. Every action and contribution, great or small, has resulted in this monument to the spirit of peace we strive to create at our school and in our community. We have joined, thanks to the generous support of the Rotary Club of Grand Forks, tens of thousands of communities around the world who strive to replace war, instability, and fear with peace, harmony, and prosperity. And I would like to share a quotation by a Persian holy man who spoke these encouraging words well before the first two world wars. Thoughts of war bring destruction to all harmony, well-being, restfulness, and content. Thoughts of love are constructive of brotherhood, peace, friendship, and happiness. If you desire with all your heart friendship with every race on earth, your thought, spirit, and positive, spiritual and positive, will spread. It will become the desire of others, growing stronger and stronger until it reaches the minds of all men. Do not despair. Work steadily, sincerely, and love will conquer hate. Abdu'l-Bahá.
Thank you so very much for those inspiring words and for the history of what you've done for today. Next, I would like to call the Grand Forks Secondary School Parent Advisory Council, Annalise Hanlon, to say a few words on behalf of the PAC. And of course, we have Angie as well. Angie Williams, the two of you.
We just wanted to share a quote from Nelson Mandela. It says, "Peace is not just the absence of conflict. Peace is the creation of an environment where all can flourish, regardless of race, color, creed, religion, gender, class, caste, or any other social markers of difference." I just want to share that.
Thank you.
Short and sweet.
And really, we thank you as a PAC for standing behind your students and playing such a role in terms of the fundraising that you've been able to provide for this. Thank you. I'd like to call our City of Grand Forks Mayor, Mr. Everett Baker.
Thank you, Maxine, and all those gathered here today. I am very privileged to, on behalf of the City of Grand Forks, Mayor, Council, and staff, to be here to share this momentous occasion with you all. In his speech in 1957, Nobel Peace Prize accepted speech, Lester Beer Pearson, who was the 14th Prime Minister, said, "Of all our dreams today, there is none more important or so hard to realize than that of peace in the world. May we never lose our faith in it and or resolve to do everything that we can to convert this one day into reality. Inclusion and respect for diversity and human rights are proven pathways to peace. A world in which all people are able to fully and meaningfully participate in all facets of society, economic and political life, will be more resilient, peaceful, and just. We usually look at peace from a point of view of the conflict between human beings. Peace is not only the absence of war, but it's the creation of a condition of harmony in the ways people live with each other that allow conflicts not to exist. For peace, there must be equality for all and justice for all. No one should be discriminated against. The welfare of humanity must come first. Any conversation can be done sitting down, with every problem can be solved by discussion. Only with peace can the future of the country be bright. Countries thrive where people understand and apply the meaning of peace and harmony." And I can't think of a better place for a peace pole to be placed than in a situation of learning. What an opportunity we have. The future sits here before us. And anything that can point them to a discussion of peace, in my opinion, is well welcomed. And I am very pleased to be here, and thank you for asking.
Thank you, Mr. Baker. So we just have a couple of things to finish off here. I'd like either Natalie and or Kenna to come and talk about what you're going to distribute right now to all students. Oh, who's going to do that? Sorry.
Bella Tomaszewski.
Bella.
Oh, Bella. So Bella's going to distribute. She's going to talk about that just very quickly here while Ms. Wolf is getting her band ready. And Ms. Wolf, you can come up as soon as Bella's done to talk about your band.
Thank you so much. Just as a little background about what we're about to hand out, so just to conclude, and as a symbol of both peace, prosperity, and many other things, we've decided to give out biodegradable wildflower sheets. If you're not sure about what biodegradable means, it just means that as these flowers grow and bloom, the paper is going to dissolve, give back to the soil, the earth, and eventually you when you have a beautiful bouquet in your home. So for many different cultures, communities, and just families in general, wildflowers are symbols of many different things. These things can range from things such as peace, renewal, healing, remembrance, triumph over adversity, and resilience. I know for my family personally, we really treasure wildflowers, especially California wild poppies, as they are a reminder of the fact that we made it, we did it, we got to Canada, and we're good. Beyond that, wildflowers are also providers. They provide pollinators with food year-round, they provide us with natural medicines, and they provide communities with beautiful, bright colors and sweet smells. So in remembering all of that for today, when you take these plants home to plant them, we ask that you do so with positive goal, intention, or just something simply to be thankful for in your mind. That can be anything from just being thankful the sun's out and shining, being, you know, encouraged to have resilience to get through to the end of the school year, or having the intention that you're apparently going to go home and find $20 in between your couch cushions, because, yeah, you can. I believe in you. I believe in all of you to do that. I'm sorry. in all of that, we do hope that you do plant them with intention, because that intention will eventually brighten up your lives and brighten up our communities the way these wildflowers do. So yeah, in some strange contemporary way, we hope that these wildflowers can show you that peace will prevail.
Thank you so very much, Bella. Mr. Don Coplo, who is the current president of the Rotary Club of Grand Forks. Here's a message from Grand Forks Rotary.
Thank you, Maxine. Well, good afternoon, everyone. You know, Maxine asked me to do this today, and this was a few weeks back, and she came along to me with a 17-page speech. And luckily, I pared it down to 3/4 of a page. Come on, you guys, it was funny. Anyways, it is indeed a pleasure to be here today at your peaceful dedication ceremony. The Grand Forks Rotary Club is honored to support and sponsor the GFSS Global Citizenship Club in their endeavor to make today a reality. World peace is one of the top 3 goals of Rotary International. At Rotary, we have no tolerance for racism. We promote respect, celebrate diversity, demand ethical leadership, and we are working steadily to advance peace since 1917. These are our central tenets of our work. Rotary strength is our commitment to bringing people together. I believe that peace starts within us and will spread to family and friends, neighborhoods, community, our nation, and the globe. It is very important for all of us to actively support peace initiatives. We simply cannot be bystanders. I have a quote for you. War can perhaps be won single-handedly, but peace, lasting peace, cannot be secured without the support of all. That's Luiz da Silva, a Brazilian statesman. Anyways, I would like to congratulate Natalie Herbert and Kenna McGregor and all the students of the Global Citizenship Club, as well as their teacher and co-sponsor, Ms. Archer, Maxime Rizika, of the Grand Forks Peace Chairperson, and all the other community sponsors who supported this initiative. Well done. May peace prevail on earth. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Don. And I do want to just add that Miss Mary is the other co-sponsor teacher and has worked in this venue for decades with the Global Citizenship Club. And can we give a round of hand to Miss Mary as well? Thank you. So that concludes our dedication ceremony for today. Thank you all for coming, and have a peaceful rest of your day. So students are going to be handing these out, and as they hand it out, I'm going to have Ms. Wolf just talk about what's going to happen with the band.
Hello. The song the band played on your way in was called All for Love, and we thought we would end with Let It Be, so I hope the lyrics have kind of gone far and wide, but if not, just sing along to the parts that you know, please. We started practicing this last week, and Gabe, Max, Caitlin, and of course our wonderful EA Shannon have done a really great job of putting together the instrumental part, and we are going to sing our hearts out, and please join us.
So this is finishing off our dedication ceremony, but please stay till after the band has finished their song. It's wonderful. Thank you.